All right, real quick, before I get started here, I went ahead a long time ago. I had Xbox Live on my regular Xbox, and things like Bejeweled, Beating Frenzy, Smash TV, Robotron, and those are all lost. I was never able to move those over to my Xbox 360. Yeah, only one that, the only two that bother me, Beating Frenzy and Bejeweled. But other than that, everything else looks good. So, here we are. Xbox Live Arcade now became Xbox Live Marketplace, and I think it's just called Xbox Store or something like that. Store.xbox.com, something along those lines. And we're going to go down, or I'm going to go down because you're going to watch. I'm going to go down the line here. I don't know how long it's going to take. I apologize for both the PS3 and the Wii U videos taking longer. Alright, and this is 1942, Joint Strike. It's a bullet hell. It's not really as good as the original 1942, which I have on Wii Virtual Console. But it's alright. I did enjoy it, but as you can tell, I don't know, I don't really achieve much in achievements, and like some of the games, like this one and NH303 NHL Arcade, I've played a lot. 3D mini golf. I don't have a single achievement, and yet I played that game like religiously for 6 months. So whatever. And I do recommend it because I think it's the only version of 1942 available on the Xbox. And then NHL 3-on-3 or 3-on-3 NHL Arcade. This is all right, but I'm still more satisfied playing my old Sega Genesis or the Super Nintendo. Either or. I have a game on both. Oh, I do. I do have hockey games on both. And they were both bought around the same time. I'm not really into hockey, so... Next is 3D Ultra Mini Golf Adventures. A rather stiff game. It looks like she's just hiding a watermelon. You can kind of tell by the fashions and everything. This game probably took 2 years to complete, maybe 3 years. It's all right as far as mini golf goes. Still golf on the original Nintendo, and then the best golf game is Top Golf 2004, I think, by Microsoft. This one's by Sierra, or Activision, or whatever they want to call themselves now. A World of Keffling. Ooh, I actually don't remember this. I've been playing it. I haven't played it 2 years, probably, but I don't remember who the deal with the Keffling. Huh. Alright. Aces of the Galaxy! Aces of the Galaxy. I really don't like this shooter, because it's not unlike 1942 or even Afterburner that you can see right there. This one and Aegis Wings, I assume that's how it's said. They're just not any good, in my opinion. They're just not fun. Both were free. That's what really gets me. I didn't pay a dime for these two. They were free. I was like just poking around Xbox Live and Arcade, and it's like, what, these two are free? Take them. This was, probably a decade ago. Maybe 5 years ago. I don't know. A personal favorite of mine is Afterburner. I like the original Afterburner, but this one is just as, not as much fun, but just as good. Afterburner Climax. And going around, I go around and I shoot things down, obviously. The closest to this in arcades today is there's this giant Star Wars machine that I can walk into and it encloses me in this pod. Yeah, that's pretty cool. So this is like that. This, in the arcade, I believe, and I might have the wrong version of Afterburner, but sit in the cockpit chair and go. Air Mech Arena. Another free game, not as in your two free games for subscribing to Xbox Live, but another free game. And I think it's online only or something. I don't know. I've just never gotten into it. I don't even think I've ever been to a match. So, because it was free, I think somebody asked me if I could download a system for a match, and I never did. Obviously, Angry Birds Trilogy. I prefer the... I have this on Wii. But actually, that's my wife's copy. I have this... my copy is on 3DS. I don't play Angry Birds on my phone. What's weird is I have lots of games on my iPhone. Or iPad. I don't have any games on my iPad. I have a lot of games on my iPad. I just don't play anything. So, this is... this is on vastly overpowered hardware. If you're thinking, okay, he bought Angry Birds, what's his deal? I had a coupon. I had a coupon to buy something, so I went ahead and bought Angry Birds for the wife. But at the time, we had a Wii in the bedroom. We had the Wii in the living room, 316 Wii. I have to now explain my Angry Birds. So this must have been through that weird phase we went through where the 360 was in the bedroom and the Wii was in the living room. Apples to apples. I played it once. I guess I got an achievement. I don't know anything about it. There's some games you can tell I've never played or I might own somewhere else. So... that for what it's worth. That's weird. I'm missing Assassin's Creed. I downloaded them all. Okay, Army of Two. I think I was screwing around in this game. It's a first-person shooter, to my knowledge. It's alright. It's nothing spectacular as far as action games go. It's like, Let me put it a different way. If you had an NES and someone gave you Cobra Command, you know, it's all right. You don't hate it. You might even be fond of it. Okay, I'm only going to speak to what I see here. Apparently, I'm missing Assassin's Creed 1 and 3 and a different Assassin's Creed. I have a different Assassin's Creed. I guess I deleted them and never put them back. I don't really enjoy these games. Now, you see, I'm going to explain something. Why is it 0-0? I mean, with Army of Two, I'm admitting I was going around, screwing around. Here, this one, and I have Black Flag on Wii U, and I'm actually pretty far on my Wii U version. But with these Assassin's Creed, I don't have three. These are the Wii U. I can't stand it, and I cannot sit through the opening. I want to press start to get on with the game. Maddox has a video explaining that. So, are they bad games? Well, from what I've played of 4 on my Wii U, absolutely not. There's 4 right there. Okay, Asteroids and Deluxe. I don't know why it's written that way. Asteroids and Deluxe. I'm not any good at Asteroids. This is actually replacing my old Asteroids cartridge for 20%. Realizing that I don't actually like Asteroids, Phil can play it till the cows come home, but apparently not here. He plays it on the Atari. So, and there's also footage of him playing an Asteroid arcade machine. Not arcade. Astro Pop is, my wife said, oh, you seem to be okay. What did she say? She said something, so I'm like, well, I can play any puzzle game and master it in 5 minutes. And this is the case with Astro Pop. I've never played it since. Banjo-Kazooie 3, Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts, is just... You know, it's one thing to have a cocky sequel done right, and that's Banjo-Tooie. Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts is not even a cocky sequel or anything. It has a lot of strange humor, a lot of inside jokes, a lot of feeling that it was originally going to be on a Nintendo system. I mean, these are mascot characters Microsoft should be marketing the hell out of, the way Sega has Sonic. Sony has Ratchet and Clank. I didn't really like this game. It didn't click with me. That's the problem. On the other hand, Banjo-Kazooie, and I'm actually very far here, almost as far as I am on my N64 cartridge. So that's pretty cool. No, actually, I'm not as far. I'm to the point where Kazooie is boots. And I haven't played this in a few years, so I think I should fire it up later. I'm not gonna... Anything I haven't bought, but the demo is still here, I'm not gonna talk about. Batman Arkham Asylum. Again, another free, but free as in I had a coupon. When I say coupon, I mean someone giving me money to buy the system, or buy the game, or something like that. Not usually, you know, Christmas gifts, birthday gifts, just random. Oh, I had this, probably had a few bucks for this Xbox card. I don't need it anymore. Or something like that. So here's a... I did enjoy this for what it is. It's okay. But it ain't great. And it ain't bad. That's what really gets me. This has everything clicking right, except the music. I can't stand that symphonic gibberish that all, it seems like, because of Batman Begins, Marvel ran with this. Oh, we need themeless music. Well, themeless music to me is music. Themeless music to me is crap. It's like somebody went bought Jump Back to use it for Symphony. But other than that, the graphics, the play control, the play mechanics, similar to an old Tomb Raider game, actually. I have a little trouble in some spots, just because I believe the controls are a little too complex in comparison to an old Tomb Raider. But other than that, it's just fine. Battle Fantasia. It's an Arc System Works game. That should give you an idea. It's a fantasy fighting game. It's a fighting game. There's no RPG elements I found, anyway. My wife likes it because there's a rabbit wizard and stuff. The characters are rendered instead of 2D animation, which is a little bit different than normal Arc System Works games. So, but other than that, it is an Arc System Works fighter, similar to Blaze Blue or Guilty Gear or Arcana. Battlefield Bad Company 2. Actually, playing that a month ago. There was something irritated me about the game and left. People are like, "Oh, Battlefield." I don't care. Battle Station Pacific has probably the worst plane controls ever. Also, it's too realistic. I'd rather play 1943. I bought this Battle Zone. Me and Phil, I bought it, but, you know, Phil came over. Phil Barnes, fellow YouTuber. And we went ahead and we were supposed to meet this kid who met us on Doom 3 to play this online. And I think we irritated him by blowing him up all the time. Other than that, it's Battle Zone. Nothing else to say about that. Here's a version of Bejeweled 2. Now, you know, that's the thing. There should be three stats on these games. Achievements, gamer score, and the last one, which also should award points, time played. This is probably the most played game on the Xbox 360. Well over level 100. In endless mode. Beyond Good and Evil HD. More like Beyond Good and Evil SD. I don't know, what was the appeal behind it? Why is Ubisoft so behind Beyond Good and Evil? It's not that great of a game. In fact, I got stuck on the first level, and after about an hour, screw it. I don't want to play it anymore. BioShock Infinite is a really good game. It's a really unique, I just wish I could press start during the cutscene, but it's a really unique take in a steampunk world. But I disagree with the fact that the fascist is a right-wing Christian, because every time we see these serial killers or fascists, like Adolf Hitler, Benito Mussolini, or whatever, they are farthest from Christian, despite their baptism. You know, Joseph Stalin, that current bat dictator of North Korea. So I don't understand that personal. That's a political attack. And, you know, the game should have been kept neutral overall, and you know, it's not even neutral on the cover there, the American flag. Other than that, though, the game is really good in design and everything like that. But because of its anti-Christian, anti-American stance, I really can't recommend it. That's the unfortunate part. Everything clicks right about the play mechanics, but because it takes that stance, I can't recommend it any more than I recommend something that promotes politics. I don't want any politics really in any of my games. The way it should be is, in this case, Battlefield has it right. I work for the government and I shoot people. Anyways, moving on. Blacklight Tango Down. The game that starts in the dark on a beach or something like that, I guess. I don't really remember. A lot of these first-person shooters are forgettable. Blade Kitten by Atari. What? You know, how come I haven't got a single achievement? I'm actually pretty far in this. It's, imagine Castlevania Symphony of the Night in a broken engine. That's the best way to put Blade Kitten. So it is enjoyable. I didn't say the play control's bad. The play control's good. But I believe it's a one-time playthrough, and I haven't gotten through it yet. So. Borderlands was free. Borderlands 2 came with the Xbox S. I had to replace my system. Dark Gage currently has it. Really don't enjoy these games. They're by the alien colonial marine people. Just didn't enjoy these. You can tell. No achievements, no nothing. People talk of Borderlands like it's something. I'm willing to give Tales of the Borderlands a try, but that's about all I can say. Brothers was a very boring platform. What more can I say? Burnout Paradise, probably one of the best games ever. And the reason for that, even though it's a racing game, is that you do everything at your own pace. It's an endless mode. That is such a novel concept that it's practically foreign. I can go and do whatever I want. If I just want to drive around while thinking about clearing my head out after a day of work or something, this game was one of the perfect games for. The other one is Need for Speed Most Wanted U. That's the only version I have. And they're both made by Criterion Games. So, you know, I've got to recommend this game, Burnout Paradise. It really is paradise just to drive around. And I can play the game as well. The Capcom arcade cabinet. I think I bought like a handful of games for it, and then I realized you're too old to enjoy. If you think of something called arcade cabinet, there'd be some better stuff. Truthfully, about Capcom, outside of Street Fighter, Resident Evil, Mega Man, Ghost of Chicago, they're a hit and miss company. And the Disney stuff they're really good at. But, I mean, they're a real hit and miss company. So is Konami. We only remember the good. Cartoon Network. punch knives, explosion, X out. This game's good, but the problem with this version is two players both have to have an Xbox Live account. This is a children's game. What family is going to... You know what? Just buy it on Wii and don't even worry about it. Castle Storm. Oh, okay, I remember this. This is a silly little game. Yeah, I didn't like it. Castlevania, Harmony of Despair. There's a zoom-in version. Actually, I think I have footage for this. For 10 games in 10 minutes. This is not a good Castlevania game. It's supposed to be multiplayer, but... It's novel. I'll give it that. Symphony of the Night. Need I say anymore? Perfect Castlevania. And if you know that it's available on Xbox 360, and I believe it's available on PS3, and PS Vita, and PSP, you would do yourself a favor. And it's compatible with Xbox One, so do yourself a favor and buy Castlevania Symphony of the Night. And if you've already beat it, play it again. It's fine art. Not fine art is Castlevania Mirror of Fate. Lord of Shadow Mirror of Fate. This is the third title, I think, of the Lords of Shadow series of Castlevania. I'm stuck on both this version and the 3DS version in the same spot. That's what really gets me. I'm stuck in the same spot. I have Lords of Shadow 1 and 2 on PS4. I don't understand. How can I be stuck in the same spot? What am I not doing right? Maybe I need to watch a long play on it. Catherine. This is a rather unique game. Censored Gaming has covered some stuff about Catherine. So some other people. I never really figured out the game, though. I think I'm supposed to sleep with Catherine. Again, free. Centipede and Millipede. Evolve. I used to play this for hours and hours and hours and hours back when I... it's been with my Xbox 360 for as long as I can remember. And it's Centipede and Millipede. The reason here... Well, I don't have it on my Wii, so this is as good as it gets for me. I do have a PSP version. I have this thing called Atari Retro or whatever, but Centipede is no good. So I would carry this around. The disk drive doesn't work anymore on my PSP. Somebody dropped the PSP and put toilets. I was able to get it back and working, but other than that, the disk drive rusted out. So this is really neat. It has neon colors and stuff. It has the original mode, which I think it does called Classic. I never played it. I always liked the neon thing. What I don't like is it shows a little guy with a crossbow instead of a spaceship or something. I always liked the idea of being a spaceship. Charlie Murder. Downloaded it, never played it. Civilization Revolution. I can talk about Civilization 2, but nope, never played it. Again, Charlie Murder and Civilization Revolution are both games that were free. Here's another one, Might and Magic Clash of Heroes, another free game. These come from you get two games a month from Xbox Live if you're a subscriber. I'm going to disclose right now, I don't pay a dime for Xbox Live. I have it until April of 2018. I don't pay a red cent for Xbox Live. I don't. And I know that sounds rude, condescending, whatever you want to call it, but it's true. It has nothing to do with whether or not I know an employee at Microsoft or anything like that. I don't pay a dime for it. I get it for free, and you can get it for free too. I'll tell you how right now. You have to do Bing points. You have to get 30,000 Bing points. So you sign up for Bing with your Xbox. You sign into Bing with your Xbox Live account. And if you're on a Microsoft Edge browser on Microsoft Windows 10, you can even get more points. And in order to get 30,000 points, it's going to take approximately 3 months. And then you can get Xbox Live free as well. You can also get $10 Xbox Live gift cards. Those, I know which games I've used those for. In fact, one's coming up right here. Command & Conquer 3. Lo and behold, I realized that even though I do have the PlayStation version of Command & Conquer on disc, or on set, whatever, and the N64 version, Command & Conquer is best played with a mouse and a keyboard. More a mouse than anything else. So, I should know that more than most people, and, again, I used a coupon, it was on sale, I got it, and there you go. This is the poo-poo version of Contra. This is worse than the PS4 version, and both versions show the arcade version of Contra just is no good. No good at all. Nope. That's weird, I have played Crackdown. It says here I have it. Did I... No, it's a Microsoft game. There's no way I could have played it on PS3. Is it on PC? Did I play this on PC? Okay, now here's some games that don't have Xbox covers, even though they should. You remember the Blades system? That's what people, I heard fellow gamers call the Blades OS, which was just fine, it was lightweight and everything. Yeah, if we had the Blade system, there'd probably be an icon here, but we don't anymore. The Wrath of Cortex, I bought this for my goddaughter. We played it once, never came back to it. Doritos Crash Course 2, or here it just says Crash Course 2. I think this is like a Wipeout or MXC type of game. That's all I remember. Crimson Alliance. Now, there is a game I deleted, which is Crimson Alliance, is similar to that, I think. This is some kind of RPG. I think this is a free-to-play. And have to buy everything else that goes with it. Now, like Assassin's Creed, I don't know why I'm missing Crysis 1 and 2. I was actually having fun with Crysis, and yet I haven't unlocked its achievement. I don't understand that. I don't. Dark Souls bored me. You can tell I got one achievement and then stopped playing altogether. I have Darksiders 2 on Wii U, so this was given free the same day I bought it on Wii U. And I'm like, so I was playing this in the morning. Then I had to leave, and then on my way home, I stopped somewhere, found Darksiders 2 for Wii U. On sale, bought that, came home, played that, never came back to this one. Now, you think with all the Darkstalkers stuff I've done, I'd have more achievements here, but whatever. Darkstalkers Resurrection contains two games and probably the worst resolution in YouTube uploading it to Street Fighter 3. But here we go. And it has Night Warriors and Vampire Savior, or Darkstalkers 3. Also, Darkstalkers 2 and Darkstalkers 3. And it has kind of a bad interface to know which game is being played or whatever. So forth and so on. And the games really look dated on this collection. Okay, here's Doritos Dash of Destruction. Free game. And it plays as these dinosaurs eating Doritos truck. This would have been great in the arcade 30 years ago. It's fun here, but it's nothing spectacular. Just the price is right. Kids love it, though. This is Daytona, USA. This one plays very well, just like the Saturn version. And that's all I need to say about it. Never played Dead Island. Don't know if I ever will. Another free with your subscription account. Or my subscription account. Dead Rising 2, my roommate was playing that. She apparently got nowhere after so many minutes. I never played it. I do have Dead Rising on the Wii, where I'm running around a shopping mall, and I never figured out what to do. And, well, that gets kind of boring. Never played Dead Rising 2, Case Zero. Never played Dead Space. Is there a Dead Space game? I get Bioshock, Dead Space, and Mass Effect all confused. I think there's a Wii version, too. Offshoot type. Never played Deadlight. Deadpool is fucking hilarious, and I really recommend this game across whatever system it's on. I mean, it's just a funny game. And I bought this, I've been waiting for my wife to play it. She brings it up once a week but never plays it. I played it and enjoyed it. I played it for about an hour, and I've been waiting to play with her. I mean, either she can sit next to me while I play it, or I can watch her play it. The point is, it's a funny game. Death Smiles is a shooter where I have to shoot the front and back. Of course, it has typical, what is it called? Baby doll anime character. It also has a sequel that I think is overpriced. It's a good shooter, but it's too damn hard. It's by Cave, I think. I do have this also on my iPad. Much easier to play. Never played Defense Grid. Never played Defiance. Okay, now you're thinking, never played Deus Ex Human Revolution? I'm gonna say Deus Ex, okay? It's Latin. It's actually Deus. Deus Ex. I have this on Wii U, and I don't know how to put that. I play it on the Wii U. I enjoyed it on the Wii U. This is a good game. And I know that's here on 360. Go ahead and pick yourself up a copy. It's also Xbox One compatible. So is Dig Dug. This is Dig Dug. I prefer the Wii U version of Dig Dug. This is emulating arcade. I'm using an NES. Apparently I've never played Dirt 3 or Dirt Showdown. Really don't care to either. Again, free games. Free. My Xbox 360 subscription. Disc of Tron. I bought this for Phil. He played it for a little while. Got bored. I was actually enjoying Dishonored, but again, after an hour, felt like I was getting nowhere. It seems to be a trend among first-person shooters. And, fuck the story. And fuck your convoluted controls. Go back to more of, you can kind of see where I was looking. If you can see it too, get there. Devil May Cry HD Collection. Apparently I had nostalgia filters on, and I really don't enjoy Devil May Cry anymore. This was like $3. This was cheap. And I don't know what it is, I just don't enjoy Devil May Cry anymore. The controls are screwed up, but essentially Doom and Doom 2 are what I'm looking for in a first-person shooter. Going around always stuff up with very little plot. That's my type of game. Here's Doritos Crash Course 2. This may still be available, strange that it's available for Crash Course. Go through the Crash Course, I guess on behalf of Pepsi Doritos. Double Dragon. No longer available, but there it is, the arcade version of Double Dragon. I like this version a little better than I like the PS4 version. At least I can stream and talk to the PS4 version. I don't know why the cover is so weird. They just switch the position to Billy and Jimmy. Instead, it's Willy and Jeff. Double Dragon Neon. Imagine Shantae meets Double Dragon. with all the strange humor and hot babes and all that stuff. A lot of people like this game. I don't hate it, but it ain't great to me. Now this sounds weird. A lot of people hate this one. Wander of the Dragon. Double Dragon 2. I don't know if you want to call it a remake or a remake. But this is... a lot of this is considered one of... This game is considered one of the worst games ever made. I don't know why. I enjoy it. I played through it a lot, even though my achievements are crap. But I don't get that. There's just some games I play a lot of, and I can't seem to make any headway on the achievements. I don't actually look at what the achievements are. But I enjoy this game, and I don't think it's a bad game. Whatever. Duke Nukem 3D. I think my problem here is simple. I have this on PC. I have the free GOG download for signing up to GOG a few years ago. Duke Nukem Forever. This game, like Deadpool, is really funny. At least I think it is. A lot of people don't like it. I like it. I don't see any problems with it. Other than it took forever to come out. Well, people were ragging on that and stuff. It's technically the fourth Duke game in the proper Duke. But, there's Duke Nukem 3D, Duke Nukem 4, ever. Okay, and then there's like other Duke Nukems. I remember I had Duke Nukem 64, then I had Duke Nukem 0 Hour, I think. Is that what it was? And then there was a Duke Nukem Land of the Babes or Planet of the Babes or something like that. So I don't know what the problem was with Duke Nukem. I think Dungeons Defenders play similar to Crystal Chronicles. I mean, Crystal Defenders. I haven't played Dungeons Siege 3 yet. There's a reason for that. I actually want to sit down and record myself playing. And that requires an investment of time. I know it's a good game. I feel it in my bones. Dust. Didn't really like that. I've always wanted every extended extra. Every extended extra stream. I wanted it on PSP, but I bought it here and realized it's not what I thought it would be. It goes for Exit. I have Exit on the DS also and on the PSP. I bought this version to play with fellow YouTuber Matt Murphy, and I don't know what to say about it. I guess he thought Exit would be fun. I have never played racing games that are just so awful. F1 2013. Glad it was free with Xbox Live, and. Wow. I don't understand. It's like that Battle Station specific. It's too realistic. And when I say too realistic, what I mean is it's exactly that. It would be like if I was in real life trying to drive these things. Fable 3, I think I started it, and then something happened. I never came back to the game. And that's how time slips out when I end up playing other games. Same thing happened to Fallout 3. I would start the game and then something would come up and then leave it be. And I'm not playing New Vegas till I finish Fallout 3. Far Cry 3, Blood Dragon. Miami Vice means Blood Dragon. Miami Vice means Far Cry. Here's Fatal Fury Special, and I have this, I kind of addressed this in the Wii episode, and here it is, and And there it is. Feeding frenzy. Oh, I guess I did get a game back. I guess it's the only game they could give me back, because I don't need Usual 1 for 360. And I don't see... this is it. Feeding frenzy. And this game's been cloned multiple times. It's essentially what Jaws should have been on NES. Here's another fun one. It's Forza Horizon 2 Fast and Furious. Don't need Forza Horizon 2 to play. But this is more mission-based than Burnout Paradise or Need for Speed Most Wanted. So, but essentially I can just drive around. If I want to do the competition, like collect cars. Much better than Activision's Fast and Furious game. Not as good as Raw Thrill's Fast and Furious. I forget how good Fighting Vipers was and how bad Fighting Vipers was. This essentially has no enhancements from the Saturn or PC version of the game that was released so long ago. But it is what it is, and I don't have any complaints. I'm slowly playing through Final Fantasy XIII, and when I get done with that, I'm coming here. That's why there's nothing there yet. But I have it here when I'm ready to play. Final Fight Double Impact. One of the accomplishments. They have accomplishments and achievements. There's actually like way more achievements than one would imagine. But the accomplishments, one of them is unlocking an episode of Street Fighter that involves Final Fight. The old USA Saturday morning cartoon Street Fighter. Then there's also, I think the game is Magic Sword. Black Tiger or something in the second game with it. I haven't really played through that. This is the arcade version. They really try to spruce it up. If you have to get a version of Final Fight, this is the one I recommend. Final Fight Double Impact. Free with the Xbox 360S is Forza Horizon. Frogger. This is Frogger. This is the way Frogger should be. Is Frogger. And the third Frogger 2. So I'll explain. On the Atari 2600 ColecoVision Go system, there's Frogger 2 3D. Then on Dreamcast, PlayStation, and PC, at the turn of the century, there's Frogger 2, Swampy's Revenge. And now there's Frogger 2, just a few years later. There's also numerous Frogger games on Game Boy Advance, GameCube. I don't know. Here it is, another version of Frogger 2. I think this game is still available, and I think it's still free. Frozen Freefall. Bejeweled meets Disney. I don't know if Disney was using it in the test pilot program. You can get this on your phones as well. You can get this on the PS4. I did a video of it on the PS4. It says Snowball Fight, but whatever. It's Bejeweled meets Disney. Game of Thrones, free, haven't played it yet, really don't care about Game of Thrones. I suppose it's the show people watch if they want to see Amelia Clark naked. The Game Room, this I like, and I don't know if I can still unlock games for it, but I like this game. I really do. It's a bunch of games, competitions, and stuff like that. Essentially, given an entire shopping mall, a virtual shopping mall, and can't buy every single game. That's what I found out. I can, but I have to place them everywhere. I don't think I have enough room to place every single game that I want. So they're having television games, 2600 games, regular arcade games, and Konami games. I have two Twin B games. in there, and many other games.
Oh,
again, a version of Centipede for 2600. I really enjoy that. Gauntlet 7 Sorrows. Not the Gauntlet game I was expecting. So I was probably thinking of Gauntlet Legends on the N64 or Dreamcast. I think that's exactly what I was thinking. Still a good game. So if you want it, you can get it. Have that iPhone. Can't get it on Xbox. And I haven't played any of the Gears of War. These are games I want to get into, so I don't have that time. That's the thing. Too much time. Too much time is required. Geometry Wars. That was free. That was free on a memory card. I bought a memory card and that was on it. How did I get it off the memory card? Ghostbusters Sanctum of Slime. This is more of a sequel, not to the Ghostbusters that came out. The one Yakumo says is essentially the third movie. I meant Retro Core. This is more of a sequel to that Data East version of Ghostbusters that came out in the arcade, which is what I thought the NES game would be. I didn't know the NES game would be a bad translation of the Atari 2600 version, which is a good game on the 2600. Guiana Sisters Twisted Dreams. Director's Cut is available in physical on Wii U. Do not pay more than $15 for that version, by the way. Toys R Us is selling them at $40. This is a good game, and you can get it here on 360. That's all I can say. It's a good game. Now, this is weird. Guiana Sisters was a response to Mario Brothers. Now it's on 360. Girl Fight. The cover implies that they're going to finger bang each other or something. I don't know. But Girl Fight has potential to become actually a very good series if somebody wanted to step in there and help. It really does have that potential. And it can go many other ways. But this first Girl Fight game is similar to Street Fighter 1. Everything is there, but because it's the only one, but not the only one of its kind, it's more on the bottom scale. So like I said, if somebody stepped in and really said, let's see what we can do with Girl Fight, I believe that a sequel to Girl Fight would be just, spectacular. Golden Axe, already talked about Golden Axe. On Golden Axe, there's Golden Axe. You can play it on your Xbox One. Gotham City Impostors. Didn't really enjoy this. It was given away for free. That's about all I can say. Don't enjoy it. Played through a little bit of it. Glad I didn't pay a dime for it. Haven't played Grid 2 yet. Guilty Gear X2. Pound sign reloaded. Whatever. Other than that, though, it's a good game. It's a good fighting game. At least I think it is. I'm into all that. What was my deal with Halo? I think it just started the game and then I just never came back. I don't know anything about these things. Happy Wars was free. So, game of gold. Contra Hardcore Upright. I don't know why they took the Contra name, but this is the Contra game we should have got. This one is by Arc System Works, of all people. So, shame on Konami for not making games in-house anymore. But yeah, this was, This is a good game, and I recommend it for anyone who's that is 360. Arm's Way by Doritos. Oh, okay, I remember. This is like just driving around in the desert, and if I was being attacked, I sure don't remember it. I just got Heavy Weapon. It's a Game Google download. So I haven't played it yet. Being pointed at by the guy. Hexen HD was free. I don't know if it's still free or even available, but it has to be, says Xbox One. But it was free. I just stumbled upon it one day looking at puzzle games. And it's an okay puzzler. But for every time I play it, I think the house is being burglarized while I play it. There's another game with gold, Hitman Absolution. Hitman and a similar series of Max Payne. Not really. That's weird. It says I haven't played Hydrophobia, but I did. Because there's a lot of swimming around and stuff in the game. I have played Hydrophobia. Maybe. No, that wouldn't fit their criteria. Haven't played I Am Alive, haven't played Iron Brigade. Jurassic Park, the game. Jurassic Park, the boring game. I was kind of hoping they were repackaging Genesis or Super Nintendo. Someone told me Just Cause 2 is a funny game. I haven't played it yet. Again, another game I want to get into. Okay, the King's Quest, just chapter one. Chapter one's always. I want to get the whole thing, but not here. I do have the whole thing. I have the whole thing on Steam. That's where I've been playing King's Quest, from Steam. King of Fighters, or KOF, Sky Stage, bullet hell shooter with your favorite characters. I have videos of this on my channel. So go ahead and find them. I play as Mai. The King of Fighters 13. You'd think I'd have a lot more achievements unlocked with these King of Fighters games, considering how much I've played them. Like I said, if they were awarding points on time, not achievements. I mean, you're thinking, okay, well, maybe if you play it more, me, I'd have more achievements. No, it just doesn't happen. King of Fighters, 90. There's a lot to say about this game that was rematched in 1999. This really turned me off from the Tomb Raider game. I think so. I just didn't like this game. I like the old Tomb Raiders. I have those downloaded from GOG, but I have a prompt running on my computer. I haven't played Life is Strange, so I was confused for Mirror's Edge. Not playing Lightning Returns till I play 13-2. Mafia starts in World War II. I don't know if I hate it or not. Magic the Gathering. Duel. Blade Walker. 2013. Or Magic 2013. Where are my other Magic games? So I'm missing games here that should be here, but aren't. Marathon, Durandal, me and Phil were playing through that. Oh, I don't know, maybe 10 years ago? 9 years ago, something like that. And we haven't come back since. I think we ran roughshod over it or something. Marvel vs. Capcom 2. This is a really bad version of the game. But, yes, the original Xbox version of the game runs on the 360. Or... Now, Marvel vs. Capcom Origins, which I don't think is available anymore, has two games on it. It has Marvel Super Heroes, and then it has Marvel vs. Capcom 1. Both are very bad versions of the game. this seems to be a trend with Capcom and Konami and everybody. They take these games that people want. I mean, you know, if they're still available, good. And then they piss all over them, though. And, you know, it's like, is it nostalgia goggles? No, because I go back to my Saturn or my Dreamcast or my PlayStation, and it's like, wow, these games were actually good originally. Now, Mercury, with its symbol, it says Mercury HG, but HG is a symbol for Mercury on the periodic table. This is similar to Mercury Meltdown Revolution. Okay, Metro 2033 and Metro Last Light, we still download these with Games of Gold, and we just never, ever got around linking up, playing against each other. Wait, that's weird. I did play Metro 2033 by myself. Metal Gear Solid 5, Ground Zero. Metal Gear Solid, graphical tech demo for your Xbox 360. Minecraft. This was bought from my goddaughter, so she played a lot. Me and Jewel got a lot of time, and this got a lot of time. Oh, I do have mirrors at me. Interesting. It's been a game for gold. Interesting. I want to play it. Now I have it. I don't remember anything of this Monaco. What's yours and mine? Is this a burglary game? Anything is a burglary game. Monkey Island 2. I never played all the way through this just because I got bored. Which is a shame because this is actually a very good game. All the humor and everything is there for both of these Monkey Islands. And I'm glad that Monkey Island is still available to some modern gamers, but there's a lot of charm in the PC original. I think the PC original, well, I know the first one's available on Sega CD, but I think these are the only versions available today. I don't know. Monopoly Deal, Monopoly Plus. Oh. Ubisoft really ruined Monopoly, and these two are about as much fun as getting my pizza. So, I'm going to still have to recommend either Monopoly Party by Infogrames or Monopoly on the N64, also by Infogrames. Those are the two good versions of Monopoly. Mortal Kombat Arcade Collection. That's exactly what it is. I think James and Mike did an episode not so long ago of these. They lack charm. That's the problem. There's a lot of charm in these games. They're not here. It's good that Warner Brothers is though keeping the legacy alive. There's still a lot of pluses I can give these games. You know, PS1. Mortal Kombat 3 on the Sega Saturn, Mortal Kombat, you know, then there's Mortal Kombat Trilogy on Saturn, PlayStation, N64. There's a lot to say about the various versions of Mortal Kombat. I mean, the controls on Mortal Kombat 2 for Genesis and Super Nintendo are just flawless. Whatever. Motocross Madness, the game that gave me my first red ring of death on the old Xbox. Ms. Pac-Man, and that's exactly what it is. It's Ms. Pac-Man because I want to play Ms. Pac-Man, so I bought Ms. Pac-Man to play Ms. Pac-Man. MX versus ATV Reflex. If I didn't like MX versus ATV Alive, why would I like this one? Dirt bike game. I like that other one. This is Naruto Storm Revolution. And was this cheap or free? I can't remember. I think it was... That's one of them. I'm stuck at the beginning. So I gotta watch a long play. Yeah, that's what happened. I get stuck at the beginning. What is with these games? Neo Geo Battle Coliseum. Imagine a bunch of people from a bunch of games duking it out. It's a decent fighting game. Very decent. Very, very decent. Excellent fighting game. So I definitely recommend that. I bought NFL Blitz because I was just in the mood one day for NFL Blitz. And it was on sale, ironically. So, hey, that worked out two ways. I still prefer the N64 or PlayStation version of the first Blitz. Knights into Dreams. Now, according to Lazy Game Reviews, every version of Knights should be in this. As unlockables or hidden features or something like that. This, again, I know I say this frequently, but it has no charm. It doesn't have any charm in comparison to the original Knights on the Saturn. I haven't played Knights on Wii, so I can't give an opinion on that comparison. It's not the game is dated. The Saturn one has charm. This one doesn't. I don't know anything about this. Operation Flashpoint Dragon Rider. I guess I played it. Is this the one on a boat? Otomedius X. On the Time Machine, the intro is there. It's a sequel to Gradius and Proteus. It has more to do with Proteus than anything else. Now, the girls are extremely hot for all the right reasons. And that's about all I can say. Other than that, they gave nickels and dimes to get the whole thing. Now, this is actually it's not just a sequel to Gradius and Proteus, Life Force, Salamander, Axlay, and so forth and so on. It's also a sequel in its own series. There's the original Otomedius. It was supposed to bring Konami back to the glory days of shooters. Unfortunately, I don't think that this did it at all. I don't know how many people actually bought this game. Outland. I played Outland. It says I haven't played Outland. I don't really like Outland. Pac-Man, can I say anymore? Pac-Man. Nothing more to it. Pac-Man. Peggle was cheap or something, and I just wanted to play Peggle. I like it. Very simple game, but drives me. It's insanely great, someone else would say. I also like this one, Phantom Breaker Battleground. But, the levels take too long. Okay, Pinball Arcade. Like I said, I got a lot of luck here. So, this, and ignore Pinball FX, Pinball FX 2. I got just a lot of tables unlocked on these pinball games that I just enjoy, really, really enjoy. Plants vs. Zombies was free with Games with Gold. I downloaded it, and then my goddaughter wanted to play it on her 3DS, so I just downloaded it there. If it's Prince of Persia Classic, then at least let me access the classic version. This is just a reskin with a backflip. That is not Prince of Persia. Also, some of the levels did not look the same. So this is a misnomer. It is not classic Prince of Persia. This is Prince of Persia Evolved. Putty Squad. This is a unique game. It's a sequel to... There's two putty games on the Super Nintendo. And whichever one is the one that plays like this is a sequel. And that's all I can say. It's pretty unique. Super Puzzle Fighter 2 Turbo HD Remix. Again, lacks the charm. Also, the screen perspective is wrong. So I'd rather play this on my Saturn. Actually, I have the PC version, which is very easy to play with the numeric keypad. Quake Arena Arcade. That was free. I have Quake Arena for free on my PC. This one was free too. I don't know. No, I'm not allowed to play it anymore. Or at least they won't let me on the servers because I was sitting around sniping people. R-Type Dimensions is not bought yet. Why is the cover missing the RBI Baseball 14? Anyways, I like RBI Baseball, and I'm glad the series is back, but... No, the only thing that bothers me here is the cover's gone. I actually like this baseball game.
Oh.
This one was free. Resident Evil Code Veronica X. That's the only reason I have it, because it was free. I'm just poking around, and I got it for free. And these two were free. These were free with Games of Gold. I haven't played them yet. I do have Rainbow Six Vegas on PC. I think that's where I played it. Rayman Origins was... this was a case of me not knowing that I already owned the game. 3DS? I think I own it on 3DS. I wouldn't have bought it here. Was it a Games of Gold? Maybe it was. Whatever the reason is, there it is, and I haven't played it yet. Resident Evil 2 Revelations. I have Resident Evil Revelations on Wii U and 3DS. This one is free, and then I think I have to buy all the episodes to get rid of it. Red Faction Gorilla. I haven't played it yet, right? No, I have, but it says I haven't. Ridge Racer Unbounded, free, using Pink Points. I remember that because this was one of the earliest games I got with Pink Points. Actually, the earliest was right next to it. I got to say, Namco is in the wilderness. They don't know how to make a racing game. I don't even think they are doing anything. Rumble Roses XX. For some reason, it is a sequel to the PS2 version, but the PS2 version just is better. Not graphically, but they look like plastic dolls. Anyways, I have a lot of videos from this game, so you can go ahead and check that out. Russian Attack. Complete absolute silence by me. Sorry about that. Yeah. I don't know what else to say. Russian Attack. Sacred 3. Haven't played it yet. Now, this is weird. Again, it says I haven't played Sacred Citadel, but I have. I found that one rather entertaining, so I definitely recommend that. It says I haven't played Saints Row 4, but I have. And then there's Saints Row the 3rd or 3. Both. Excellent game. Humorous game. I definitely recommend Saints Row game. Samurai Showdown 2. This was because I had a control problem with the Wii Virtual Console version. So I bought it over here. This has a control problem also. I still prefer my Windows version. Samurai Showdown Sen has to be one of the best fighting games I've ever seen. It puts to shame Samurai Showdown 64 and Samurai Showdown Warrior's Rage. I don't know, one or two. This is really, really good fighting game. Sega Soccer Slam. Imagine Mario Strikers Charge, which is available on Wii U eShop. Imagine that without Mario characters. Just as much fun, but having the Mario characters, well, let's face it, people just want to play as Peach or Daisy. But having those characters there really, really adds to charm. I bought it here before I bought Mario Strikers Charge. I found the two games for the same game. And you've seen plenty of uploads from this Street Fighter 3 Third Strike. It says Online Edition. I play with my wife in all sorts of ways, but usually my wife is the other opponent, and you can tell sometimes I just wail on her. You notice she doesn't jump, but she's fighting. Shoot many robots. This game was hilarious. That's all I can say. I don't really know. Truck and Roll, bought from my goddaughter. I guess she played it once and never came back. Haven't played Sleeping Dogs yet. Haven't played Sniper Elite V2 yet. There's the second episode of Sonic the Hedgehog 4. So after we beat episode 1 on WiiWare, we went ahead and bought this. I don't know if there's any more adventures. Well, speaking of adventures, there's Sonic Adventure, which I unlocked the... not called Battle, is it? Anyways, I unlocked the... I'm just going to say the GameCube version. And, again, nostalgia filters or something. I don't know. It's just this, Sonic CD, they're just better on the systems they were made for. I don't know how else to put that. I mean, these aren't bad versions of the game. And I guess for people who never played the original versions of the game, I suppose that these are okay. But I just prefer the original version. Sonic the Fighters, bought for my goddaughter, and well, look at that, almost all the achievements are unlocked. So she must have liked that one. I do have some video of it too, of me playing. Soul Calibur! I have Soul Calibur 2, and like multiple versions of that one. And I don't have Soul Calibur 3. Then I have Soul Calibur 4, which is on disc for some system. And then I have Soul Calibur 5, and I don't know if there's any more. We played these games a lot. Still lacks the charm of the Dreamcast original. I do like Soul Calibur 2 that I have. I know it's also available for download, but I have the original disc. And the reason I like it is because it is the original disc. So... you know, the original versions of the game, not these translated or emulated versions, have a lot of charm. Like this one, Soul Calibur 5. Never played against a computer. My wife likes this because it's easy to play. And I got videos of this up. Spartacus Legends. Apparently I played this and never came back. Spelunky. I would probably like it. Explosion Man. Haven't gotten around to it. SSX. I actually enjoyed this, but I guess it didn't unlock very many achievements. This is not a remake of SSX, this is a sequel to SSX. That's the way games are. Strania, the Stella Machina. Strania. Bullet Hell. I've only unlocked one achievement. I've played this a lot. Same with the next one, Street Fighter 2 Hyper Fighting. Don't get it. And the next one, Street Fighter Rage 2. Now, if you notice, I'm glossing over some of these, and sometimes there's just not much to say. I prefer Street Fighter Rage 2 on the Wii because it's the actual Genesis version. This one has like all these reskins and stuff like that. Or smoothing graphics, whatever. I don't like that. It's Strider. And it must not have been very good, because I still prefer the original Strider. Super Meat Boy, that was free with GameCube Gold, and it was downloaded. It would have been downloaded anyway. But I've been waiting for Matt Murphy to come over and go ahead and film him playing. Super Street Fighter 4, hated it. I don't know. I'm so confused by Street Fighter 4. That's all I can say. That one was free, though.
That one was free.
This one was not. This one wants the second player to have a separate account. What I think I'm going to do is re-download it on PS3, if it's available there. But then Ultra Street Fighter 2 is coming out for Switch, so I don't know if I'll do that or not. And that's weird. It says I haven't played Supreme Commander. I have. I remember talking to my wife. I'm like, I like this game. Something was right about this game, and so I enjoyed it. Star Wars, The Clone Wars, Republic Heroes. Say that three times fast, and I will not. My wife wants to play this, so I've been waiting for her to have some time to sit down. Okay, so the only Tekken I don't own is Tekken 5. So here's Tekken 6. It's $3. I'm not joking. It was $3, so I bought it. I have to say, for beginners, the two fighting game series I recommend is Tekken and Soul Calibur. For fighting game beginners, those are the two easiest fighting games to get into. Here's a very excellent Tekken Tag Tournament 2. I have it on Wii U as well. This one was a Games of Gold. So it was free. And that's why I haven't played it yet, but I do recommend it. If you have an Xbox 360, go ahead and get this. If you have a Wii U, go ahead and get it. Tempest. I was in the mood for Tempest one night, bought it, played it. Haven't been in the mood since. Terraria. I've been meaning to buy this for my 3DS so I can play it on the go. I got pretty far and then somebody played my game. Totally wrecked it. Tetris Splash. I haven't unlocked all the fish here. It's a very good version of Tetris. It has this gimmick that's supposed to be underwater. That's about all I can say. Other than that, it's Tetris. I do believe I have footage for this later for the show. The Cave. Played it yet. The Force Unleashed. Another Star Wars game. I think I was playing the Wii version of this, but I never owned it. I think I rented it from Redbox. King of Fighters 2002. Limited. Wow, okay. It's one thing to say this lacks charm. It's another to say that the original on Dreamcast lacks charm. The Orange Box. Half-Life 2 episode. I have Half-Life 2 on regular Xbox, which works on the 360. This has Team Fortress 2 and Portal. So, I enjoyed Portal. I really did. I don't know if it has, it has regular Half-Life 2 and Episode 1, but I still beat Half-Life 2 on the regular Xbox. I watched him get pretty far in my game, and then I screw around. So I really never got far in Half-Life 2. Actually I did, but I was just screwing around. It says I haven't played the Raven. I have. I remember it had like this intro that I kind of wait to get through. Simpsons Arcade, you can see the videos of that. Walking Dead and Walking Dead Season 2. I haven't played Season 2. This Walking Dead, obviously, you can tell I've played it. My goddaughter got through it really fast. I don't really care about The Witcher. Here it is, The Witcher 2. Don't really care about it. The Wolf Among Us, I heard, is a good game. I thought it was part of Walking Dead, but I think so. I think what confused me says from the makers of Game of the Year, The Walking Dead. So, there you go. There's what caused the confusion. I enjoyed Thief. I don't know why I haven't come back to it. Maybe I just forgot. Titanfall Deluxe Edition. How much? $3. No joke. I was goofing around the Xbox Marketplace. I saw it for $3. I bought it. Why? Believe it or not, I can't sit through the intro. So, let me press, to any developer, or anyone, let me press start, please, so I can get through it. Alright, Turtles, 1989, you've seen videos of this. I don't know why, those are the 2003 Turtles. But anyways, there it is, and its big flaw is I can't do local two-player. I've played the game plenty of times, and I can't do local two-player. I don't like that. Danger the Ooze. Shantae meets the Ninja Turtles, and that's where. Out of the Shadows. Wow, this game's boring. That's all I've got to say. Boring. Play as April O'Neil in the first level, and I've never gotten past that. It is boring. All right. One Turtle game that's not here is TMNT, based on the TMNT movie that's currently on Netflix. I don't know how long it was on Hulu, then it was on Netflix, then it was back on Hulu. It went from Netflix, Hulu, Netflix. This is made Mutants in Manhattan. I do have TMNT. Oh, and the reason I don't have it here, Dark Gage has it on Xbox 360, and it's a one-player Turtles game. Baffled me. The reason I don't have TMNT, I have the Game Boy version, and I have the Wii version, or I rented the Wii version, I think I did. Okay, that Lara Croft game, I think, is the one I enjoy. Oh, Mutants in Manhattan. I like the premise that it's based on the Black and White Mirage series, sort of like Manhattan Mission. That was available on PC a long time ago. What I don't like is it just takes me too long to do the levels. That's a flaw. You know, you can get any version of this game. I believe it's the same game all around. And, you know, just for shits and giggles, they should have put it on Wii. Tomb Raider. This is essentially a remake by Crystal Dynamics, not by 4. 4 is gone, I believe. Or dissolved into Square. I don't really know what happened to 4. I just did not like this game. It's not Tomb Raider to me. There's certain attributes to Lara Croft. Lara Croft and Bayonetta share a lot in common. And Lara Croft is supposed to be... Bayonetta's got more of the attitude of Lara Croft than the current Lara Croft game. So that's a shame. Totem Ball is a multiplayer-only game, I think. And that's why it's only been played once. Toy Soldiers Cold War? Must have been a game of gold. Trigger Heart... Retrocore can say this, I can't. I'm going to say it in Latin. XLE Cup. That's how it's said in Latin. I'm just going to call it Trigger Heart. It's a bullet hell. It's on Dreamcast as well. The Dreamcast one has a lot of charm. This one has, well, it doesn't have the charm, but it has the fun. Now, what's weird is I've beaten it 3 times, and it here tells me I never had an achievement. Tron, that was for Phil. He played it. After he played it so many times, he left. Tron Evolution, that was a game of gold. It's also one of my first Xbox 360 games, and I don't remember it. It's been quite a long time. No, wait a minute. This can't be... No. Let's go back. That is one of my first Xbox 360 games. Which Phil was visiting. I let him play. This is not. Trouble, which is Neo, is a bullet hell. A cute 'em up as well. And it's ridiculously hard. I've never gotten very far in the game. No, I've never gotten past the first level in the game, actually. Here is, it's been delisted, Turtles in Time Reshell, Turtles in Time Poo Poo Edition. Lacks complete and absolute charm. The graphics don't fit. It would have been nice if they talked to Konami and had the original and unlockable. Still, I have to recommend it. Can you get it anymore? Absolutely not. That's a shame, though. Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3. That's exactly what it says on the tin. This is a pretty good version of the game. But, unless you're an expert, it's really hard. Undertow. A lot of people have Undertow. Almost everyone I know who had an Xbox for over a decade, an Xbox 360, has Undertow. Why? Well, Undertow was given out for free when they had a severe hacking outage. Well, the hacking caused a severe outage of the Xbox 360 service. Now, Sony did something similar. They gave people a choice of a handful of games. Unfortunately, my PSP was completely missing at the time, so I couldn't get the Little Big Planet for PSP or something like that. I don't know if Little Big Planet is actually available on PSP. Undertow, though, was the same thing. And more like a slap in the face compared to Sony's offering. Sony really gave a better offering for an outage and a hack. And here, this is, well, it is what it is. Uno. This one I have all the extra decks and everything. This, to me, is a good version of Uno. I used to play it for hours and hours and hours online. It was also one of my first... it was available on this disc. It also has Boom Boom Rocket and Pac-Man CD. I went ahead and downloaded it because I lost that disc for years. Now I have the disc. And I lost the case, though, but I have the disc. And I'm almost tempted to also buy the other two just so I don't have to worry about that disc anymore. Virtua Fighter 2, exactly what it says on the tin. Unlike the GameCube. Wow, I just called the game Wii and GameCube. Unlike the Wii Virtual Console version, this is the real Virtua Fighter 2. Why? Fighting Vipers. Again, it lacks the charm of the Saturn version. So I do have a Viva Pinata game. This one is the sequel, Trouble in Paradise. I played it. I used to watch Viva Pinata on Foxbox. Anyone remember that? Warface Beta? I swear I deleted this. Oh yeah, I played through it and stuff, but I swear I deleted it. I gotta check this out after this broadcast. Warlords. That's exactly what it is. It's Warlords. This is actually a very good version of Warlords. I do recommend it. Not a good version of Warlords, and I don't recommend it. Wolfenstein 3D, and I don't have it covered. I'm going to say something real quick, even though those games are not online. I like these Watchmen games, so that's why they're here. It's not like I'm flush with cash, okay? Wolfenstein 3D, I don't like that they change the control scheme, though everything from the PC version is here. Roll the Tanks, I remember I was like blowing stuff up at the beginning of the game. Worms? Someone's playing my copy of Worms. How can I have any achievements unlocked in Worms when I've never played Worms on 360 before? Ever. Do I have it on a disc? It's impossible. It's an Xbox Live Arcade game. I feel wrong. X-Blade. I just downloaded this. I'll be playing it a little later. X-Men Arcade. It's delisted. This is the arcade version. I mean, it has all the modes and everything. I like playing this. I like playing it with my nieces and nephews. I like playing it with my friends. I like playing it with my wife. This is a really good version of X-Men, the arcade game. And it's a shame it's not available anymore. XCOM. I haven't played that yet. ER Kung Fu. I played that a little too much. It's a certain silliness. Young Justice Legacy. Everyone warned me this game would be bad. No, I didn't listen to that. I'm still in shock over the Worms. And then I'm missing a few. I'm going to go check that out after we're done. We're done here. Here's Zuma. I can play... If I'm right, I think I can play Zuma all day, all night. And I'm thinking of Luxor. I can play Luxor all day, all night. Alright, any questions, comments, whatever. Copyperbinky@gmail.com